I'm Molly with GRS. On today's show, you just brought home your baby. Here's some basics to get started.
Well, I have a wonderful electronic invention I want you to see. It looks something like you.
Welcome back, guys. So you just got your machine, you don't know how to set it up, and you don't know what the heck all these knobs do. Well, we made a video for you on setting it up. Go check it out. Here's the link. Once you set up your machine, come back and watch this video, and we'll show you what all these knobs do. Okay, so to get started, we'll give you a general overview of all the different knobs. So you have your power button. You have these three knobs at the top of the machine. Those are for air pressure. You have your foot control and hand control selection knob. You have your auxiliary knob, strokes per minute, and then your handpiece selection knob. To start off, go ahead and turn on your machine. And then we have the 901 handpiece. This is a good overall handpiece for removing material and doing lighter work. We're gonna set your strokes per minute to start off at 23. This is kind of personal preference. So I actually like mine around 33, but I might turn it up or down depending on what I'm doing. Just make a few test cuts at different strokes per minute and see what you like to your taste. Something that is unique to our machine is that you can set your strokes per minute or your speed, and then you can also set your air pressure. So we're gonna go ahead and add some air pressure to our handpiece. You're going to hear your handpiece start to knock. And I usually hold it up to my ear, but I'll hold it up to the microphone so that you can hear that. So there it is, it's starting to knock a little bit. You wanna go just beyond that. And now it's ready to use. So I want you to notice how when I push down on the foot pedal, the handpiece starts to go right away. I ask you to notice that because some people think that more air pressure means more power, and that actually might hurt you. I'm gonna show you by turning it up. Now if you watch the foot pedal, you'll notice that there's actually a lag in it before the handpiece starts to move. So it's not moving until there. That is why we listen for the knock. And then that's your sweet spot. If you want to use your hand control, you turn this knob, and then you have to adjust your Airtact. We recommend putting it around 10. Tune your handpiece at the air pressure, and then your hand control is ready to use. If you want to switch to a different handpiece, turn this knob right here. And then you'll retune your handpiece. So a common problem that we see is that people haven't turned the knob far enough. So you can actually hear it kind of bleeding air, and there might be a lag in your handpiece also. Just make sure you turn it all the way. And you might also notice that when I was tuning the handpiece, you could barely hear it knock. If you have a newer handpiece that's not broken in, you might not be able to hear it knock very well. This is what this knob comes in handy for. The bias knob, if you open it up, will make that knock a little bit more audible. So go ahead and tune it, and then close your bias knob back up. Another use for the bias knob is what it's actually doing is creating a little bit of an air leak. So if you're running your machine at a higher speed, when you go to use your handpiece, you'll notice there's actually a little bit of a lag before it starts up. You just need a little bit more pressure And so this bias valve, if you open it up, creates a little bit of an air leak and gives you that smoother start. So essentially what it's doing is allowing you to fine tune your handpiece and giving you a bit of a smoother start. Also, you have your auxiliary knob down here. That's for an air gun, or if you have a rotary handpiece. This is our 850 handpiece. It plugs into the back of the machine, and then when you turn up your auxiliary, you'll hear it start to run. So that's what all the different knobs do. If you guys have any questions, let us know and we'll try to answer them for you. Hopefully I didn't melt your brains. The suggested Instagram user of this week is Sam Alfano at master_engraver. Sam is awesome. Go check him out. If you want to be our suggested user of the week, then tag us on your next post at GRS Tools. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out all of our new videos. Check us out on social media. And like this video, subscribe. There should be a button over here somewhere. Throw your comments down below and be a part of the conversation. Yeah, thank you.